Early childhood education programs face increasing pressure to use classroom and child data to inform decision-making. With support from the Early Childhood Education Research Alliance, REL Northeast Islands examined the collection and use of data in 7 preschools in a mid-sized city in the Northeast.
This alliance really wanted to understand the relationship between children's early childhood education experiences and their early learning outcomes. When we started talking to our alliance members about possibly doing this study, we learned that they didn't have the data in their jurisdictions in order to examine the associations between early learning outcomes, early childhood education experiences, and classroom quality. And so we needed to take a step back and think about what data are preschools collecting, how are they using that data, and what challenges are they facing. And so that became the focus of this study. We conducted interviews with a teacher and an administrator at 7 preschools in a mid-sized city in the Northeast. In addition, 2 of those preschools provided data that we analyzed in order to provide information about how preschools might want to use their data to inform program-level decisions. With both the interviews and the data analysis, we focused on 3 domains: early learning outcomes, classroom quality, and dosage, or children's exposure to preschool. So we learned several things from this study. First, all the preschools reported collecting data on early learning outcomes, dosage, and classroom quality, but the process through which they collected this information really varied. As an example, in terms of early learning outcomes, 4 of the preschools used a commercially available external assessment system, such as Teaching Strategies Gold or the Work Sampling System. The remaining preschools used an informal process, such as collecting work samples or collecting portfolios of their children. All preschool teachers and administrators reported using the early learning outcomes to inform individual instruction and to inform their teaching practice. Similarly, 6 of the teachers reported that they use the classroom quality data to inform their teaching practice as well. We also learned that teachers and administrators were providing data on early learning outcomes and attendance to parents. They provided this information in order to keep parents informed of their children's progress and to encourage them to send their kids to school. However, the teachers and administrators reported that it could be challenging to figure out the best way to communicate that information to parents. These findings suggest that preschool administrators may benefit from additional state guidance about how to best collect and use data. In addition, administrators and teachers may benefit from additional guidance about the best ways to share information with parents.